Hey all, so in this lecture we will look into the synchronization problems. So basically synchronization in the sense, let me take you to an aside, okay. So assume that I am clicking links how to sell, okay. It navigates to some other page. In this page I want to click on this link, which is click here to register with PaisaPay, okay. So the concept here is, after clicking that link, so how much time should Selenium wait for this link? Okay, if you don't give any time, within a seconds it will try to identify this link, and by that time if our internet is very slow, it takes time to load this entire pages, okay. So before loading itself, if it takes 30 seconds to load a page, but WebDriver will not wait for us, right? So WebDriver don't know about internet, our internet connection, so it will fail. So how you will write, tell to your script saying to wait this much period of time and then fail? So how you will instruct your code? So we can do this with the help of waits, okay. By putting the wait in the script, we can make the Selenium WebDriver script to be a pass for a few seconds and then resume after the link is displayed. So in this way we will handle the synchronization problems. So in real time we will see this in many, because today our internet connection, LAN connection will be very fast and the page will be loading within 3-4 seconds, but tomorrow sometimes it takes 15 seconds and scripts will be failing. So how do you manage this? So let's see now. So there are totally two types of waits in WebDriver. One is explicit wait and other is implicit wait. So explicit wait in the sense, you forcibly make the WebDriver script to make a pass for the a few seconds, and the step for that is thread.sleep, right? By giving this, if you want to make the script to sleep for 10 seconds or for 5 seconds, if you want to make it for 5 seconds, then give 5000 milliseconds. The argument thread.sleep takes in milliseconds. So 5000 milliseconds is nothing but 5 seconds. So if you will see some red line throwing error, move your mouse here and add throws declaration and error will remove. Okay, in this way, you are saying this WebDriver script to wait for 5 seconds and then resume. Some code of clicking, write the code to click on element, so it will be done. This is called explicit wait. Okay, but there is some loophole in that. Tomorrow in this page I want to click this link, okay. After clicking it will navigate to some other page again, okay. And again if you go for thread.sleep saying 5 seconds here, and again next link displays, click here. So if you keep on putting seconds for each and every page, then you know that might be a cause of performance problems, right? The script will take 5-10 minutes to complete the execution, so you can't go ahead and do for every step. So in that cases you will declare some amount of time globally, so that it, for example, globally I say wait for 10 seconds. Okay, if the link loads before the 10 seconds, I mean if page appears before the 10 seconds, then go ahead with the script. So come from the pass state to the resume state, right? So I'll show you in the practical example. I'll let you know what is the difference between implicit wait and explicit wait. So to write implicit wait, driver dot, you have manage dot timeouts dot implicit wait, and how long you need to give, you want in time unit dot seconds. So this is a big step you need to write, so we can't avoid this. If you want to 10 seconds, just directly mention 10, okay. So our 5 seconds, we are concentrating on 5, right? Yeah, give your 5. So you know what the specialty of this step? Yeah, it's different, sorry. The parameters should be reversed. So the difference between explicit weight and implicit weight is, in implicit weight, it will wait for a link, okay, 5 seconds. If the link is page is loaded in 2 seconds, then script will continue by clicking on it. It won't wait for 5 seconds. That means it will wait until the link is displayed. If it displayed before 5 seconds, then it will continue. So it saves our time. But whereas in explicit wait, though the link is displayed in the 2 seconds, but still it wait for 5 seconds and then the script will resume. So that is the main difference between explicit wait and implicit wait. So if you declare it globally 5 seconds, it applies to all the steps in the script. You need not write every time thread dot slip after each and every step. So if you write globally in this way, it applies to each and every step in the script, so that whenever you click on link, you enter something while changing from one page to other page, minimum it wait for 5 seconds. That's up to you. It's depend upon your application how much time it takes. You can write 10 seconds, but that doesn't mean that it waits for 10 seconds for each and every step. It waits for a link. If it does not appear in 10 seconds, then script will fail. If it appears in 4th second, then script will continue. It does not wait for 10 seconds. In implicit wait, so maximum 10 seconds it will wait. If it appears before that, script will continue. Okay, this will be a very efficient one compared to this. But whereas in this case, it appears or not, it will wait until the time what we mentioned here, and it applies to only the step wherever you write. If you write here, it applies to only here. If you write here, that doesn't mean that thread dot slip will do for every step, because this is a local one and this is a global one. Okay, it's a good practice to write implicit wait globally, declaring some 10 or 15 seconds by contacting with your dev team to make sure that how much time the application takes. So generally people go with 10 or 20 seconds. That means hardly 20 seconds it will wait an entire script to load the page. If it appears before, it will continue. If not, script will fail. Okay, so that's how we handle synchronization problems in WebDriver. Clear the difference between explicit and implicit? So remember this. So you might be asked a question to differentiate these two and which will be the better one optimize the script. Okay, so that's about this lecture. Thank you.